हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी वेर डिस्कसिंग एन एक्सट्रैक्ट आई हैव अ ड्रीम बाय मार्टिन ल्यूथर किंग। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इंट्रोडक्शन एट द सेम टाइम सम पार्ट ऑफ दिस एक्सट्रैक्ट और लेसन। नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ the lesson I have a dream. We are going line by line. They have come to realize that their freedom is inextricably bound to our freedom. You know that there is a procession of Negro people in America and the leader is Martin Luther King. And there is a discrimination between white people and black people. White people are suppressing them, humiliating them, and that's why they are doing a procession. They are doing agitation against white people. But Martin Luther King doesn't have any kind of a biased approach in his mind. And that's why he says that their freedom is inextricably bound to our freedom. The freedom of white people and freedom of black people is equal. Their freedom is bound with our freedom. That is, the freedom of white people is bound with the freedom of Negro people, black people. We cannot walk alone. And as we walk, we must make the pledge that we shall march ahead. We cannot turn back. There are those who are asking the devotees of civil rights, when will you be satisfied? We can never be satisfied as long as Negro is the victim of the unspeakable horrors of police brutality. The same situation is there like India. Police brutality is also there. Police were harassing the Negro people, humiliating the Negro people, torturing the Negro people. Some white people used to ask, some policemen used to ask that, when will you be satisfied? And the answer of Martin Luther King to this question is, we can never be satisfied as long as the Negro is the victim of the unspeakable horror. Unspeakable horror. You can imagine that what kind of a horror might be there in America about Negro people's situation. We can never be satisfied as long as our body is heavy and with a fatigue of travel. Cannot gain lodging in the motel of the highways and the hotels of the cities. Negro people were not allowed to enter in the motels and hotels in the cities and in the highways. So unless and until they are entitled to enter in the hotel and motels, we will not be satisfied. We cannot be satisfied as long as the Negro's basic mobility is from a smaller ghetto to a larger one. There is a small places of Negro where they are living in America. Unless and until they transform from one place to a bigger place in the cities, they cannot be satisfied. We can never be satisfied as long as our children are stripped of their selfhood and robbed of their dignity by signs stating for whites only. There are various such kind of discriminating slogans and notices on school boards and benches where the words are written and that are for whites only. Unless and until these boards be removed, we will not be satisfied. The boards must be demolished or vanished from that place. Each and every place is entitled to Negro people also, because they are equally national people like white peoples. We cannot be satisfied as long as the Negro in Mississippi cannot vote and a Negro in New York believes he has nothing for which to vote. There was no right of voting to the Negroes also at the time. Negro people in Mississippi could not vote at that time. And Negro people in New York also believes he has nothing for which to vote. Why we should vote is the question before the Negro people. And that's why there is a sound insecure feelings in the mind of Negro people because of that. And that's why we means Negro people will not be satisfied unless and until they have the right of vote. No, we are not satisfied, and we will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream. Justice should be there. Unless and until justice is not there, we will not be satisfied. What the white people entitled for, the Negro should be entitled for the same. So, this is the basic question of what we can say, the discrimination between white and black people. I am not unmindful that some of you have come here out of great trial and tribulations. Some of you have come fresh from narrow jail cells. Some of you have come from areas where your quest for freedom left you battered by the storms of persecution and staggered by the winds of police brutality. You have been the veterans of creative suffering. So all these people, Negro people, basically suffered from a various tedious and tremendous brutal situation. Police brutally beat them. Police always did injustice with them because of only they are Negroes. Some of participants in the procession come from jail cells, some from areas where your quest for freedom left you battered by the storms of persecution. Strange situation is there, actually was there. So we will not be satisfied unless and until we have a right of equality. We are equal to white people. We are men, they are also men. Whatever they receive from the nation, Negro people should receive from the nation, because they are the native of America. And that's why this is the right, in other words, fundamental right for the Negro people, that they should have each and everything as white people have. Continue to work with the faith that unearned suffering is redemptive. Go back to Mississippi. Martin Luther King appeals to the participants in the procession that go back to Mississippi, go back to Alabama, go back to South Carolina, go back to Georgia, go back to Louisiana, go back to the slums and ghettos of our northern cities, knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. There is no any cause of despair. There should not be despair mood in your mind, because the situation is changing and the change will appear definitely in our future life. And that's why go to your house back once again and assure them that the situation is changing and change will happen definitely. I say to you today, my friends, even though we face the difficulties of today's and tomorrow, I still have a dream. Martin Luther King here says that I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. This is a very important line. We hold these truths to be self-evident. We are the self-evident that the truth, and the truth is all men are created equal. So there should not be any kind of a discrimination between white and black people. So this is our demand, and that kind of a justice which we must have. So this is the appeal done by Martin Luther King before the government of America, and at the same time he wants to encourage Negro people that change will happen in our life definitely in the future. Further, he says, I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. This is the message of brotherhood given by Martin Luther King. He says that the son of slave and the son of slave owner, that is white person, and son of a slave, that is a Negro person, both sons, a white son and black son, should sit together on the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. Now we are living in the atmosphere of injustice. We are in the position of oppression. We are waiting to change this situation into freedom of justice, transformed into the oasis of freedom of justice. He further says, I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation. What he says that, I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. What is the important thing in the personality or the person is his character. Character is most important than his color. What kind of a person indicates the person is a good or a bad. It doesn't mean that black color belongs to bad people and white color belongs to good people. There are many peoples in white community also, they are bads, and there are plenty of good peoples in the black community also. So the person should not be determined by the color of his skin, but by the content of his character. So this is an important message given by Martin Luther King to the Negroes and to the people of America. Remaining part of the extract we will see in my next lecture. Till then, thank you.